not have to turn in the review yet. But thank you for asking.
Yeah, I just wanted to have the
number. Oh, I got you. Sure, I think it's all three of those yours.
They're not doing the pledge and stuff today. All right, so I need y'all's phones, smartwatches turned in. I do not need the test review yet. I'm going to wait until it's fully completed when we've done the second half of the unit, and then I'll give you a grade for it. So I don't need the test review, but if you had any work that you did not turn in on time or any incomplete work that you did that you wanted more points for and you went back and finished it, if you did not turn that in the Google Classroom already, you need to turn that into the basket. It'd be the last chance for those late works. Then the handout y'all picked up will be your unit reflection. Remember, we just like first semester, you don't get to keep the test in your binder, so this kind of goes in place of that. So you should fill out the top piece of that. And then clear your desk off so we can get started. This will be no calculator. This test is a bit shorter since it is basically half of what we normally do. So the benefit there is you've got certainly have time to slow yourself down, don't work so quickly to make careless mistakes, check your work as you can, as you work through the test, and you should still have time to look it all over for time's up. Nobody last period was getting close to being pressed for time, so. But in the end, it settles up to 50 points. So a lot of 1 point blanks, no partial credit on those. Obviously, anything more than 1 point will get partial credit, except for the two or three multiple choice questions we have. Four of them are multiple choice, it looks like. So no partial credit on those, so double check those before you turn it in. And there was one tiny typo on here, which I don't think has messed anyone up, but let me go ahead and tell you what that is before you're too deep in here. But for all of the forms, if you go to question three, look at the answer choices. Question number three for all answer choices. A lot of those answers, actually all of them, do you see how there's a little square in the answer? Okay, that square is just the font error. All of those are supposed to be multiplication symbols. So the little block in question three, and all of the answers, those are supposed to be multiplication symbols. But that should be the only thing, I think. So take your time. I'm turning it into the box as you finish. And we don't need to move on to anything new today, so if it helps to spend the entire time, then please do so. in the box. Thank you.
I
soon as you, this looks good. Okay. But you are solving a quadratic, and when you solve the quadratic, you need to put everything on one side set equal to zero.
Oh, okay.
You put some of it here, some of it there, because when you do this, this doesn't work this way.
Okay.
You took the square root and let it cancel out x squared, but then you ignored that the 2 was a square root 2.
Oh, okay.
And then trying to dig that out's a problem. So from here, you should have subtracted the 9x over, so everything was on one side. Factor it. That gave you two answers. You have to plug those two answers in. One of them was extraneous. 5 was not.
Okay.
So try it again, and if you get stuck again, you can ask. Keep it, and then once I have you finish the rest of it, when we do the rest of the stuff, I'll have you turn it in later on. Thank you.
So that looks good. So if this times this equals zero, mm-hmm. either this could be zero. So if you set this equal to zero and solve, you get negative 1/2. Or that could be zero.
Oh, okay.
So that would give you 5. And again, you still got to plug them in up here. Because okay. when you plug in negative 1/2, you're taking the log of a negative, which is not possible. But when you plug in 5, it's fine.
Okay.
So you're almost there.
Thank you.
Thank you. got all the tests in. So again, we don't need to move on to anything new today.
So you've got about almost 35 minutes. If you've got something you could work on for another class, that would be ideal. Before I turn the screen off here, though, I haven't reminded you guys since I saw you last Friday that we will not be in here on Wednesday of this week. Tuesday and Wednesday of this week, they're doing testing in this room, so we have to go to another location. Tuesday doesn't affect you, but Wednesday will. So that is on this agenda. I also put it in Google Classroom, but especially if you guys park way down there instead of up here or something, it's going to be a lot of work to come up here to remind yourself that you're actually way down there. So you might want to have an alarm go off a few minutes before class so that you head the right direction. But that is Mr. Williams' room, room 1105. Any questions about that? Okay, and with the test review, again, make sure that you keep it because I am going to ask you to finish it after we do the other two sections, and then I will collect it for points. So I just didn't collect it yet, but don't think that it's just not for a grade and throw it away or something. So it'll still be collected and give you some points for participating.